Now I am going to solve this problem 140. In this problem, it is said that the rigid pole and cross arm assembly of problem 2105 is shown again here, right? So this is that same assembly that we have discussed in the problem 105, right? So now in this problem, it is said that determine the vector expression for the moment of the 1.2 kN tension about point A. So first we need to determine the vector, the moment vector due to this tension T at this point O, and then about the pole Z axis is right. So then we need to find the component of the moment about O along Z, right? And it is said that find each moment in two different ways, right? So it is said that use two different ways. So we will try to use two different ways to find the same moment about O and the component of the moment along Z axis. So from the solution of problem 2105, this is the T vectors. So for this, go back to problem 2105 and learn how to find this T vector, and then come back to this problem 140. So now I will start from finding the moment at point O. So the moment at point O will be equal to R cross F. So as I have told you people that we can choose any R vector from the point of rotation to any point on the line of action of the force, right? So in this case, we can choose two different R vectors, right? So let's suppose if I choose this as a R vector from this O to this point D, let me make it a vector, right? So let's suppose if we choose the moment arm vector is ROD, right? So if I write that this is ROD, and instead of F, we will write that T vector. So we will take the cross product of ROD cross T. So to find the R vector, we need to have the coordinates of this point D, right? So if this is the origin, so then this point D is on the Y axis, is right? So there is no need to travel along X, no need to travel along Z, and only we will travel 3 meters along Y, right? So these are the coordinates of point D. So now we can represent that R vector directly. So the R vector will be 3J, right? Since O is the origin. So 3J cross 0.321I plus 0.64J minus 0.962K, right? So I can draw this diagram again and again. So I, J and K. So moment about O. So 3 into 0.321 and J cross I. So J cross I is minus K. So I will write minus K, right? Then plus 3 into 0.64 and J cross J is 0, right? So this will become 0. And then minus 3 into 0.962 and J cross K is I. So if we solve this, so we will get the moment about O due to this tension T in this cable. When we solve this, so we get this moment at point O, right? So this is the X component of that moment and this is Z component of that moment, right? So this is the part A solution. But as we find this vector representation of this MO, so we find one solution for the second part as well. In part B, we were asked to find the moment about O along the Z axis, right? So about the pole Z axis. So this is the component of MO along Z, right? So we can write that MO along Z, right? So the moment, so this is minus 0.963K, right? So this is one solution. So we can write directly that moment about O along Z is minus 0.963K, right? Now, to solve this same, to find this same moment about point O, we can have this as a moment arm vector. If I define this as a moment vector, we can have this as a moment vector as well. So now if we want to find the moment about O for this same part of this problem. So what we will do, we will write that the moment about O is equal to, now this will be ROC cross T vector, right? So now we will find the coordinates of point C. So to reach this point C, we will travel this much distance along the z-axis, and since this point C is in the xz plane, right, so there is no need to travel along y, and along x we will travel this much distance. This is 1.5, but it is in the negative x direction, so I will write minus 1.50, and along z we need to travel this much distance. So this is 3 meter plus 1.5, so as a whole it is 4.5 meters. So now we can write the moment arm vector in terms of these coordinates directly. So the moment about O, and this moment arm will be -1.5i plus 0j plus 4.5k and cross T. So this is 0 point, again the T vector. This time I will use the determinant method, so I will write I, j and k, and -1.5, 0, 4.5, and this is 0.321, 0.641, -0.962. Now when we solve this, so we will get that same moment, right? So you people can check it yourself. So we will get this same moment. So I will write that this is -2.886i, -0.963k, right? So this is the second method. We can choose this as the moment arm, and we can choose this OD as a moment arm. Even we can choose moment arm like this as well, right? So it could be our moment arm, but the whether it is possible that we can find this vector or not. So we choose that vector which is easy for us to be determined, right? Now I will use another method to find this same component of moment along the right. So this is the vector. So the second method is that if we resolve this T vector into its components, right, or if we consider the components of this T vector, so we have already found that components, right? So if I draw these components of this T vector, right, so this is along the positive I direction, right? So if I draw, so then this will be one component along the positive x. This will be Tx component, and then there is Ty component along the positive y, so I can draw. So this one is Ty, and Tz is in the negative z direction, and this is -0.962, right? So this could be the Tz vector vertically downward, right? And this is exactly at this point C. So this is Tx, Ty, and this one is Tz, right? So now to find the moment about Z, we will use the inspection method. So the component of moment about O along Z is equal to, so as we can see that this Tz is parallel to the z-axis, so it will never produce any moment about the z-axis. This Tx is intersecting the z-axis, so it will never produce any moment about the z-axis. So only Ty will be producing the moment about Z, right? And if we look into this Ty from the top direction, so the perpendicular distance of this Ty from point Z is this 1.5 meters. Right, and this Ty will produce the moment in this direction, right? So this will try to rotate this in this clockwise direction. So if we curl our right hand fingers, so the thumb should point out in the negative z, right? If we curl our right hand finger in this clockwise direction, so our thumb will be pointing in the negative z direction, right? So now we can write that Ty into the perpendicular distance, so it is 1.5. And since it is in the negative z, so I will write minus k. So I will write minus, and Ty is 0.641 into 1.5, and this is k. So when we solve this, so we will get this same moment about the z-axis. So let me solve it. So this comes out to be 0.962, which is approximately equal to this one, right? So we have, I have rounded this off to three figures, right? So it was 0.962 more than 5, right? So I have rounded this to 0.963, right? So both of these are almost equal, right? So it is minus 0.962 g. So this is another way to find the component of a moment about O along the z-axis, right? So this is the solution of this problem.